frozen to the bone. There's darkness in your soul.
Hey, what's up, parasites? Welcome back to another episode of Venom Vlog. And I want to talk about something that I could be reading too much into. So if I am, let me know. But, you know, Tom put out this cool post on Instagram with our typical trio, you know, our Venom trio of Kelly and Jake and Tom, who have all been together since the first movie. Kelly came on and did some of the, I think, later drafts of the film. I don't think she was one of the original writers. I can't remember actually what order it went in. But she worked on the first film as a writer, worked on the second film as the sole writer. And now she's going to write and direct the third film. And then she's producing it with Tom. And, you know, they're bouncing ideas off each other. So I'm really curious about this film to see how these two just get to let loose. And you have Jake there, too, who's, you know, does stunts for Tom, who also will come in and chime in on ideas and say, hey, here's something we could try. Here's something we can do. And the collaboration there is really unique. And it's something I've been following over these few movies. And now I'm excited to see kind of all three of them, you know, and then everything else, you know, involved in the production, like Hutch and all these other producers and people that came on in the second movie. Some of them, I think Hutch came on in the second movie, and to see all of them kind of working together and just kind of cutting loose. I'm really curious because with superhero movies and everything nowadays, they're not, you know, there's not a style to a lot of them. There's not a uniqueness to a lot of them. A lot of them are just kind of bland and cookie cutter and kind of play it safe. And I really hope with this Venom film, they have some style to it and they, you know, maybe have to play safe in some areas so they don't alienate the audience that they made in the first two films, but also try something a little different and possibly wrap everything up. And that's what this post is. You know, I saw when Tom posted this picture, he said that he was, you know, happy of Kelly and her success and growing from writer to directing and how he's really proud of her and how he enjoys working with her and how they enjoy each other's company and sharing ideas and stuff. And I love that that was part of the post and that he included that. But the first thing he put in the post is what this video is focusing on, because I know they have fun. I know they like each other and everything. And we've talked about that in previous videos. But in this, you know, we haven't talked about this, the possibility that this is the end of Tom Hardy as Venom, which, you know, at the beginning of the post says the last dance. And I'm really curious, am I reading too much into that? Is this the final Venom movie that's going to star Tom Hardy? You know, I'm curious because they could wrap it up. I mean, it's not like Venom has a bunch of rogues, you know, and villains that you can just pull out of the comics and put into his movies. He pretty much has Carnage. And then over the course of the years, you know, they added other characters in, like, you know, you had Demogoblin at one point, you know, fought Venom with Morbius, you know, which was a cool comic book. You know, obviously he fought Juggernaut at one point, but I wouldn't call Juggernaut a rogue by any means. But then you had Carnage, obviously, is the biggest villain, you know, to Venom, is that, you know, character who has been done a lot of different ways in the comic books now. And we'll talk about one of the newest ways soon in an upcoming episode. And we'll also take a look at him in the latest Spider-Man 2 video game. Spoiler alert for that game, but that video will be coming up soon too. So yeah, we'll get to some more Carnage stuff. But yeah, so they did that in the second film and it kind of wrapped up, I think, the Carnage storyline. Unless the symbiote, I still have a theory that the symbiote that went into the MCU, that little sliver of, you know, Venom, I was thinking that was the Carnage symbiote getting away from Venom. Because remember, Venom ate Carnage at the end of the second movie. And I was like, that'd be cool if the Carnage symbiote went into the MCU and it bonds with Tom Holland and turns him into Spider Carnage. That would be something we haven't seen on screen before. And that can get you away from doing another Venom arc in a way. Or, you know, I guess you could have Venom show up and help stop Carnage or Spider Carnage. But, you know, I don't know. We'll see. You know, it could be a part of Secret Wars or whatever. Who knows what they're going to do with that movie? It sounds like a big mess, too. So, but with, you know, and then I mean messes and like a lot of comic book movies seem to have been lately and they're not performing well. And a lot of them, that's because they have big budgets. And Venom, the good thing about it and what it has going for it is that it has a more moderate budget, you know, normally around $100 million, which is great because these movies end up making five, six, you know, and plus $100 million each movie. So let's hope that, you know, this film keeps that budget and, you know, around that budget and then also has that level of success that the first one definitely had, and then the second one had as well. Wasn't as much as the first one, but it also came out during the pandemic, so it did pretty good for a pandemic movie, I feel, where it was like between $500 and $600 million off of $100 million budget, which is pretty good. So, you know, I don't know. Is this the last one? I mean, could they end it? And who would be the movie to end it on. Would you do Toxin? A lot of people keep talking about Toxin. I heard rumors about, you know, multiverse stuff, you know, and Venom having visions of the multiverse. But when you look through the comic history of Venom, you know, you can't pull a lot of enemies out for Venom. You know, they did Riot in the first movie, and that was just like, okay, we're going to do the Life Foundation symbiotes because we're loosely basing this on Lethal Protector, but then we need to get to Carnage. And then after Carnage, really, where do you go other than Null, which, you know, I'm not a big fan of Null, but it does make sense. If this is the last dance and they want to do something big, you want to tie it. Also, if it's a trilogy, you want to tie it back into the first one. Like I've always said on this channel, where, you know, you want something to pay off what happened in the first movie. The first movie was hinting at Invasion, right? And that's where every Venom comic seems to go, where symbiotes just come down from the stars and bond to people. Even in the newest Spider-Man game, which will, you know, you'll see more footage of that soon, there's just symbiotes everywhere. In the game, they did the thing with from Donny Cates where they had the spiral, the Ryan Stegman, Donny Cates run, where all the symbiotes had spirals. You know, that was kind of neat that they threw in that lore or teased it or hinted at it. So maybe they could do that for this film. Who knows? I mean, there's a lot of different paths they can go. It can start with Toxin, since a lot of people seem to want that character. And then, you know, Toxin could lead to Null or summon Null down to Earth, since Riot is gone and Carnage is gone. There's no other symbiote to really bring Null down here. And Null could take a completely different form. It could be, you know, a man, a woman, you know, it could be neither. It could just be like a giant alien monster, CGI monster. Who knows where it's going to go? But my curiosity here isn't so much what the story is, although if you have opinions of that, we can talk about it down below. My curiosity here is this the final film? And it sounds like from this post that that could be the case. Now, does that mean you won't see Venom somewhere else pop up, you know, in this shared Spider-Man universe? Yeah, hard to say. I mean, I'm sure if they can get it to happen and make it happen, they will. But I also think like this movie franchise is kind of Tom's thing and Kelly's thing now. And I feel like if they really want to just say goodbye on something, they will. And they'll, you know, and they'll walk away from something if they feel they put a good, you know, final stamp on it. So that could be the case here. Maybe that's what they're gearing up for, is to say goodbye to Venom. And if that's the case, that's fine. You know, we've done, by the time this movie comes out, we'll be around episode 1000, which is probably where I'm going to end the show anyway. So for me, that would be okay, because I'd be like, all right, well, they're leaving. If I feel better about leaving, because, you know, part of me, even though I want to end the show around episode 1000, part of me still feels guilty if they keep making more Venom stuff, like, you know, that I want to follow it. But I do have to put an end to a chapter in my life at some point with this. And then I think maybe Tom and them feel the same way. And, you know, they've been working on this movie and franchise since, what, 2017, around that time. 2018 is when Tom was officially announced as being cast, but he could have been working on stuff before that or had negotiations before that. So that's a pretty long time. You know, he's already been 5-6 years in. And then by the time this movie comes out, maybe 7 years. So that's a good chunk of your life to spend with a character. And same here on this channel, that's a good chunk of life to spend with a character. And, you know, there's other things and other topics we can talk about one day. But for now, at least we're on board for Venom. We still got Venom 3 coming out November of next year, so I'm excited for that. That's around the 6 or 7 year anniversary of this show, because we've been doing the show pretty much as long as the movie's been in production, the first film. So it'll be a nice end cap as well if this turns out to be the last dance for Venom and Tom Hardy together with Kelly and Jake and everybody. So what do you think? Is it the last dance? Let me know down below. And if it is the last dance, go ahead and tell me what you think you would want to see in the storyline. You know, I'd love to hear your ideas. You know, think it'll be Null, think it'll be Toxin, think it'll be both, think it'll be an Invasion movie. I heard Ari Arad say that when they were making Carnage, that he really wants to get back to that. So who knows how much influence he has on this? You know, you never know. So, but I do know if you're looking at the source material and you're looking at the comic books for Venom, there ain't a lot of stories left to tell. They did Life Foundation characters, they did Carnage. You know, yeah, there's cool little individual stuff you could do, Anti-Venom, all these things like that. That could all still be squeezed into this movie. You know, you could have Venom lose and get corrupted or something, and the only way to break out of the corruption is to invert his costume. And, you know, if they bring Mr. Negative in, that'd be freaking awesome if they had a live-action Mr. Negative do that to Venom in the movie. But other, if they do other means, if they bring in Alchemex, you know, tie it into the Spider-Verse, there's a lot of things they could do. But that would be cool to get a battle where Venom become, you know, Eddie becomes Anti-Venom, and he kind of does, you know, the Ends of the Earth thing, or, you know, that big Spider-Man. No, it wasn't Ends of the Earth, but it was a Spider Island, I think, where, you know, Eddie as anti-venom, kind of almost like in a spiritual way, you know, like Jesus in a way, kind of sacrificed himself to cure everybody of being infected with the spider virus. You could have him do something like that here with and curing everyone from symbiotes. And that could be a good way to end the character in the movies. So yeah, but still have a hint of like, you know, Anne and Dylan and, you know, whatever you want to tease at the end, but just have a good farewell to Eddie. And who knows, he could even live at the end if you want him to, but you could give him a big moment like that where, you know, from Spider Island. So I don't know. I got a lot of ideas in my head, obviously. So I want to hear some of yours. Let me know down in the comments below. And as always, we'll continue down there. Oh, Venom, Last Dance. Will it be true? I don't know. We'll find out, I guess, in a year from now, probably. So let me know what you think down below, and we'll keep talking again, like I said, down there. See you in the future. Peace.